So, hello everyone, welcome back to a new video. Today I'm going to show you how to build a much larger and more efficient version than this one here that I showed in the last video. So here I just, it's using for one plant, it's using one observer, one piston and one redstone, and the rails below. But it's quite expensive if you want tons of it. So I came up with a new idea. Like this farm over there, to just make it with a flying machine. So you have the price for the flying machine, and per block you need just a few rails to collect the items. So we start here on this block. Here, I'm now placing here a little floor, and you can make it up to 1, 2, 3. Yeah, so you can make it this wide. I don't know how wide it is. It's 12 blocks wide. That's a lot. A 12 block wide sugarcane farm. So I'm now just gonna place here some blocks, and then I'm gonna tell you if I'm finished. So now I've finished. I've built this 12 wide area with a 2 block high wall around it, and also at the end. And now we need to fill up this area here with hoppers, so I'm just here, 3 hoppers in a row, like this, and then just some hoppers facing into them, just a few hoppers facing into them, here at the side, and the last row, so that every item comes to the front here. And now I'm just gonna I'm gonna mirror it. So here are the hoppers now. In the next step, we have to place some rails, like in the other version. So here we need to place some normal rails. I'm just using 3 powered rails now, per slice here. For bigger farms, you need some more. And now you can just go here and place some redstone blocks in the middle, or just use the cheaper trick and place some levers underneath them, activate them, because they don't cost any redstone. You just need a cobblestone and a stick, and that's really cheap. And those building blocks of UTC, you can use any building block, but it must be a full block. Now I'm gonna place here the next row. Next, so you have to do it with any row, and you can expand it up to, I think, maybe 200 blocks or so. You can build it really large, but to the sides you can also make it a bit smaller to the sides, and the minimum is 6 blocks, the maximum 12, but I would just recommend using 12 blocks because it's the cheapest one. Because the flying machine it's just a little bit more expensive, because you need for the flying machine per block to the side you need a honey block more, but a honey block or a slime block, and it's not very expensive, so it's much easier just building a 12 wide. And from the length, the minimum is a few blocks. You can also make a smaller than this, but if you want a smaller version of this, it's just easier building that version over there. So here I've nearly placed all the rails. And in survival mode, if you build a giant farm, a giant version of this farm, you have to be careful with the powered rails, because you have to place tons of them for a really large farm. Nope, don't connect your rails. I don't want to use cobble stairs. Now we place here some more. I'm just shifting to place them on those hoppers there. And now every item would be collected here. So it's, and I recommend building this a bit higher in the air, because you need quite a lot of storage, because you get thousands of sugarcane with this farm. It's just crazy. So, here are a few chests. This should last, this only is enough for a few hours. This storage here. Place two hoppers. You can also use one, but because there are, and sometimes there come as, because if you harvest there are so many items that two hoppers are just better for the farm. And now in the next step you have to place here some more blocks. And now we need to make the field here. So, because you now might think, but on dirt blocks you can't just place the sugarcane, you need some water. Yes, that's true, but there's a little trick. You can, there's a layout with which you can just build it super easy. You have to place some cobble stairs, some stairs or slabs in there at the bottom and waterlock them, and then four blocks dirt. Next stair, four blocks dirt, and the next stair would be here. I'm just gonna place this pattern, and the next one will be two blocks offset, so it would be here, or one block, yeah, two blocks here. And now four dirt blocks, next stair, dirt blocks. The next row is gonna have it here, this first stair. You can also just place them on the rails, it's much easier. The next row is gonna be like the, is, how it's gonna be? So I need to place here. Here's the next one. I know it's not gonna be like this. It's gonna be here. Yeah, now I think we got the pattern now. Because the next one, no, it's not a pattern. It's quite a large pattern. I think now we must have. Yeah, because we have now at every block, we repeat the pattern now. Four blocks, stair. And now I'm just gonna repeat it and show you when I'm finished. Another trick, you see those rows here now? You can also just place them here from the one that's two before, so the next one would be here. It's something that I just noticed here. So here and here. It's just because here are some rows diagonally. Just a little trick. Now all of them are filled up with water, but you can't place, but now you couldn't place a sugarcane on every block. For example, this one here. And for this, you just have to go here for the pattern and place here another cobble stair in the wall. Put some water inside here. And now you can place it. You have to do it at some parts. Here's the next one. And so on. So it's just what you have to do. And here at the top are also some spots. Like this one here. You just have to place here a stair next to it and waterlog it also. The reason why we are using some stairs or waterlogged stairs or slabs is that the water then can't destroy those rails underneath, that the hopper minecarts can just drive there. So I'm gonna show you when I'm finished now. Now I've finished all the field, and now you might ask, how do we harvest it? So for that we need a flying machine. And the flying machine needs some non-removable blocks like leaves, obsidian, or some glazed terracotta. You need something like that here for the bottom row. Here, I'm just using leaves because they are the cheapest. The sides, we can just place any blocks. It mustn't be any full blocks, just you have to place them so that no items can get out of it. You can also use glass or something else to look inside. Here's some more leaves. It's quite funny. Here's the desert and they look like this. And here's the plains biome and they look like this. It's quite a funny change. At the corner, you mustn't place those leaves. And now the flying machine. it's quite complicated in Bedrock Edition because those two-way flying machines don't really work the way like they work on the PC or Java Edition. So here we're now placing it there. So we just need any block here for starting flying machine. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 11. Was it? Yeah, this way it should look now. You need to place here a sticky piston and a piston. Was it? This way, yeah. No, it's the other way. It's important to place them in the right way. Now you need here the next row of honey blocks. Then you place here a sticky piston and here a piston. So the sticky pistons are in the middle and the pistons are at the side. 4, 5, 6, 7. Now here another block that can be moved. Just here an obsidian block to stop the flying machine. Just temporarily place now an obsidian block or an extended piston like here. Yeah, instead of an obsidian block, you can also just place here a piston and extend it with a lever behind. It would also stop the flying machine. It's much cheaper. So this here would also stop the flying machine now. And now because it's the first trip, you need to place an observer this way here. The observer at the top is just temporary. This side and also this side, you also have to place one. And now if I would update one of those observers, it would launch the flying machine. But we're not completely finished because we need a station to return it easily. And for that we need here a sticky piston and a honey or slime block in front. Instead of those honey blocks, you can just use slime blocks, but it's much cheaper with them. You just have to have a bee nest and have to harvest it. It's so easy. Now you need to somehow, yeah, because this next you need a delay of three ticks or so. Place some redstone here. It only works in Bedrock Edition this way. An observer here, looking that way, so that the pistons will push and pull the observers. But if the flying machine arrives from the other side, they're at the other side, so they have to be pulled in the right position. Now you can just remove this, just a temporary block. No, this wouldn't work. Oh yes, it would, because this honey blocks can't go there. You now have to somehow make a little stair for the redstone, so that you can just activate it with a button or a daylight sensor maybe. That would be the easiest. Just getting a daylight sensor, placing it a few blocks away from it. Like here maybe on top. And then it would activate at day and night. So it would activate once at the morning and once at the evening. It's the easiest way. And this isn't finished now, because we also need the same return station at the other side. So I need to get a piston for stopping the machine. It's 1, 2, 3, 4. This block? Yeah, we can stop it here. And now we could just remove this here and start the flying machine by just pushing it once that you invert it. So it must work now. It's flying over the field. flying and flying, and it works. So in the next step, we need here the return station. So just temporarily place a piston here, an extended or obsidian block in front of it so that it won't launch. A sticky piston here. A sticky piston here. Honey blocks in front of them. Some of those blocks here. And just some building blocks. Repeat transfer ticks. An observer. So if it's a small, you could just put a cable here to so that you can just activate it with a button or so. But if you build a large one that's even bigger than this version over there, you should use those daylight sensors because it's just 1,000 times cheaper. Four blocks here. And then a daylight sensor. Where is it? Here. Here and now. Yeah. It's just activated. And now we can remove this. Push it once. And now it will fly over to the other side. None of those sugar canes have grown so far. I don't know, but maybe we're just unlucky. It sometimes takes a while for the sugarcane to grow. And the next step, we need some hopper minecarts. There's a trick, just place two of the... Huh? Just place two of them, destroy one. Yeah. Now they're pushing each other. Yeah. And now it's working, the item collection. So any sugar cane that grows here would be collected now. Oh, the flying machine just flew over here. And now I recommend to just place... It's flying again, okay. Placing here some blocks. Ah, because the signal strength changes every time. That's the reason why. So it's flying over here every few minutes. But somehow we didn't have a single sugar cane. Weird. Or did it just not see it? No? Maybe I'll just wait a minute here. So now the farm here has grown a bit, I can just remove this obsidian block because I wanted to wait for it, and activate it. So now the sugarcane flies over, and you see it, some of those sugar canes get stuck in front of it, and just fly down here. So I'm gonna put this here, one of those sticks in the chest, and the rest of it is just coming from here. To prevent some of those landing on here, we can't prevent all of them, but we can prevent a few of them from landing on top of there by just placing some leaves at the top here. That's the reason why I recommend to use some leaves. They're cheap and they can be destroyed from those observers if they are in the way. So just place here another row of leaves on top so that they get pushed down, because the blocks that are on here, I can quickly demonstrate it by just placing here an obsidian block, launching this flying machine now, and now I can just throw the stack of sugarcane on top of here, destroy this obsidian block, place here a lever that it activates, and now you see this sugarcane over there, and now it slides down, and we just have to wait for it a bit. It should disappear any moment because of a hopper minecart. Why? Has it somehow stopped? That's weird. Maybe because it's exactly the corner over there. I don't know why. Maybe I could just use a normal bucket on it here to make it empty. Yeah, now it gets picked up. Maybe just place it this way. Put here some water and place sugarcane. I don't know why it wasn't collected, but it should be. So, yeah, and you see here now some of those leaf blocks got destroyed. I'm just stopping the flying machine now again. Oh, sugarcane just got harvested. Here, launching it again. And now those leaf blocks got destroyed, and the other ones would never get destroyed, so you could just place a relay terracotta or so there. The two levers aren't there, but this is what the farm has inside here. So, and if it doesn't work for the first few minutes, you have to wait, because somehow you need to wait for a long time until it activates the first time. And just set it on 4 ticks, would that work? Yeah, that's very important to set the repeater on 4 ticks over there. That's a mistake. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please like this video, write a comment, or subscribe my channel. See you next time.